101.1 Kevin Manno, sitting with Mr. Brian Head Welch.
What's happening?
It's awesome, dude. I love you so much. I don't even know what to talk to you about. There's so much stuff.
We could talk about going to the movies.
Everything you've ever done.
132.
Interesting.
Okay.
Man.
Yeah.
I'm definitely unique, I guess, right?
Yeah, your debut solo record comes out on Tuesday,
you know,
right?
No
yep.
problem.
Saving
I'll
for
be
myself.
Sure.
We spun flush a few times. All right,
man.
Yeah,
thanks.
Man, we like that. What is the message of the record, I think, is my question. That sounds kind of cliche, but I know that you've gone through a lot of changes.
Yeah. The message of the record is just the reality of those changes, you know, what
right.
happened to me. You know, I got songs about leaving Korn and just struggling with that and struggling with addictions and spirituality, and it's just the stuff that's happened to me. It's not, you know, it's not preachy at all. It's just life experiences, you know.
Sure.
And I never sang before, and I had a lot to say because I went through a lot, so it was cool. I communicate best through music, so it was really cool.
That's awesome. And how reflective of the book is it?
There's some similarities because the book, I let it all out, you know, and so.
I heard something from you, a quote or something a couple weeks ago. You were talking about Korn and the relationship with the guys, and you said you love them. You're not done with them entirely, but right now it's just not right in your life. Is that accurate or no?
Yeah, you know what it is? It's like I had a real alcohol and drug problem, and I hung out with these guys with that problem for 10 years, and we just drank, and even if, you know, Jonathan has been sober for like 10 years, I think, but I was always drunk around him, so when I get around people that I used to be drunk and do drugs around, it makes me feel weird, like that old guy, so I just need some time apart for right now, and, you know, I look forward to seeing him again one day, but...
You ever talked to him?
I talked to him last summer, and I almost hooked up with the bass player, Fieldy. We were going to hang out, but just, you know, things happened and didn't work out, but... Those guys are always on the road, you know, so...
Mm-hmm.
Too,
you know, Jonathan's doing his own thing, right?
Yeah, it's like... That's another reason why I left. I was like, dude, you guys want to work too hard. I got to, like, sit down for a minute. But it's all good, you know, and there's nothing but good vibes between us.
Awesome. That's good to hear. I know you're doing, like, a Borders tour. You're coming through Chicago. You're going to Oak Brook, I think.
Yeah.
Borders, they're just doing a signing, signing the record, signing books.
Yeah, I like to get personal with the fans, you know, and just get out there and... then we're going to talk about maybe doing this live and, you know, in the near future.
But have you played shows?
I haven't played a show since 2004 December.
Really?
So I just did a shot a video though, so that was similar, and it was just it's just like riding a bike. And you get up and play. It's what I do.
Oh, that's interesting. It's been 4 years since you played a show.
4 years, dude.
Jeez.
I'm like, I needed to sit down and rest though, but you know, if you would have told me 4 years, 4 years ago, I would have said, no, I won't do it.
Well, I'm glad that you're back, man. I wish you nothing but the best, nothing but success. Thank you for giving us the time, dude. It's great to see you and talk to you.
Thanks.
Brian Head Welch, Q101.1.
Yeah.